A domain is a region where a particular set of rules apply, or where an activity takes effect. For example, a school environment is a domain that is meant for learning, and it has some well-defined rules. A market is a domain where buying and selling of items take place. The key concept in a domain is that it defines an area where a given rule is valid or where control can be achieved. On Ethernet-based networks, we often hear the terms collision domain and broadcast domain. Today, we'll learn how to properly identify a collision domain and a broadcast domain on a computer network. Hello guys, today we'll talk about collision and broadcast domains. Let's play a game called electrocution. In this scenario, all cats are connected directly to the cable that supplies power. When we turn on the power source, all the cats will feel the shock since all of the wires are joined together. In networking, these cats are said to be on the same collision domain since they receive the shock together. A hub provides this functionality for computers, as every device on the same collision domain receives the same message sent from a source. In the second scenario, we install a switching unit here so that all cats will be isolated from one another. When we activate the power source, no cat will be electrocuted at first. We can electrocute any cat of our choice by performing the right connection. On computer networks, we say they are on different collision domains based on that isolation, and a switch provides this functionality. We can also send data to one, multiple, or all computers based on what is called a MAC address. Let's talk in networking terms now. What is a collision domain? A collision domain is a physical segment of a network where there is a possibility of signals colliding with each other. Unless otherwise stated in this presentation, all links work in half duplex mode, meaning that you cannot send and receive data simultaneously. If both devices attempt sending data at the same time, a collision may occur. For this reason, we say the entire region where there is a possibility of a collision is called a collision domain. Although a collision domain may be larger in size, it will still be considered as one collision domain. So, if only PCA and PCB were to exist on this link, this is one collision domain. If this link allows for sharing, other devices may expand this collision domain and make it larger, but it is still one collision domain. A bus network like this one, for example, is a single collision domain network, because all links directly connect to one another. If we use a hub instead, we still have a single collision domain because a hub logically functions like a bus network. In summary, a segment consisting of only cables and or physical layer devices such as a hub results in just one collision domain. What is a broadcast domain? Firstly, we need to know that hubs always send data in broadcast mode, and switches may send data in broadcast mode only when necessary. With this, a broadcast domain is any region of a network through which message broadcasts can be propagated continuously without interruption. Basically, a broadcast domain ends where a layer 3 device exists, such as a router. Let's get this concept from this animation. Assuming PCA sends a broadcast message on the network, it is received by Hub A. Hubs send broadcasts by default, so it floods the message and a copy of this message reaches Switch A. Switches will always flood messages that are specifically broadcasts. Switch A floods the message to all of its connected interfaces. Looking at the scope of the message so far, all devices are on the same broadcast domain since they receive a broadcast message sent by PCA. This network consists of one broadcast domain. If we attach another network here using a switch and a couple of computers, we can now see that we have two broadcast domains on this network. Why is this? A router will receive and process a broadcast message, but it will not forward the broadcast message into another network. Sometimes, broadcast domains are referred to as local area network segments. Finally, every interface on a hub belongs to the same collision domain. Every interface on a switch belongs to a different collision domain. And every interface on a router belongs to different collision and broadcast domains. With this basic information, how many collision domains do we have on this network? There are 8 isolated segments on this network. Hence, there are 8 collision domains. Check out the questions on the next slide. If you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget to turn on notifications so you'll be the first to know when we release a new video. Thank you for watching.